Jinnard. And this is Ninku Daini Tan, or something like that. Ninku Dai Tu Da, Ninku Dai Tu Tama, or the Neve, Japanese 2, don't know. Anyway, it's a Game Boy game I got as a kid, back in the day. Got it at a convenience store called Junkatoo. Just in the, had a rack of used games, and yeah. It only exists in a Japanese version, so stumbled upon it, saw the crazy cover art, got it, and actually, yeah, turned out to be an interesting little board game RPG. Roll the dice, move ahead a square, or whatever the roll is, a few squares. Collect items, upgrade your health or your magic, and then encounter enemies and eventually have some epic boss fights. And the art is pretty cool. I like it. I like the music too, but that's a high score. Yes. Well, I recorded the video playing first, going kind of quickly but not too fast, and I'm recording this afterwards. So let's begin with the story. I don't know the story, but I looked into it, and there's something about an evil empire or whatever, but as a kid, I made up my own story, and I still kind of stick with that now. So here we have the Ninku. These are the good guys, the descendants of the legendary, mythical Ninku, who basically protected the world, or, well, protected Japan. I always thought of it was in Japan in my mind. Protected Japan from the evil nihilists, or whatever luchador mask-wearing guys. The nihilists! They believe in nothing! Alright, we're already in the game, so, two brothers, they must be debating over who's going to do the dishes. They play, rock, paper, scissors. Perhaps they're twins, like Danny DeVito and Arnold Schwarzenegger in the movie Twins. And don't forget your onigiri, those rice balls. You'll need them. Maybe that's why they did so many dishes. So many dishes left to do. All that cooking. So you have basically, if you choose the shoe, you get to walk, and the bag is items or change party members. So at the beginning, you get those rice balls, and I eat them up right away. Increase your health. And then here in the, when you choose the shoe, you go to that menu with basically the D-pad, the cross, has four different options. The top one is just to roll or to attack in battle. The one on the left is to change characters. The one on the right is all your items. And the bottom one is your special powers. Aha! We got a rice ball square. So those are beneficial things. The rice ball squares, you get good stuff, people who give you things and help you. And you get the fish bones, the dead fish, fish bones. Then what happens? The negative stuff happens. The masks, or those little demon heads are... Oh no, not this guy. Yeah, the demon heads are enemies. And, yes, you have no choice in the experience of the putrid stew. You must. You must drink the putrid stew. You have no choice. But some are worse than others. Choose wisely. Right, so the demon faces are basically enemies, and I might get into a fight here. Yes. Alright, first fight. It's against a large rat. So, one of my theories is that maybe it's an alternate reality, the world, and time travelers or something. The original Ninku, they were from the future, and they knew all the horrible things that the nihilists were going to do, and they foresaw terrible, terrible things, so they went back in time to try and change it, you know, prevent Japan from entering World War II or something like that and not getting hit by atomic bombs. I don't know. This is just my imagination. And unfortunately, there were, of course, the nihilists to time travelers that, well, followed them. So the world, you know, let's say there was no World War II, there was peace that reigned, but sadly there were evil time travelers meddling with things, waiting for their chance to strike. Yes. And somehow they're created anomalies, so we've got mutants and stuff. And, yeah. So we've got the kid to start, and now got our best friend, I guess. Yeah. You don't have to go to the city, I don't think. I kind of forget. Some houses, some cities you have to go to, others, if you don't go to them, doesn't matter. Sometimes you get free stuff, or items, or things. There's story elements at each house, but I don't know what they are, so. Ah, this girl, she always gives you 50 magic points, like a back massage or something. Yeah, so you can go back and forth with your roles. You can kind of choose however you want to go and use strategy. Maybe grind a little. If you see those scroll squares, that's for the squirrel training. It lets you boost your health and your magic up real high, really quickly. Now, that last guy we saw, kind of funny looking. If you have items, then he'll randomly take all of one of those types of items. I have no items at this time, so he has no effect. Okay, squirrel training, and I choose the health option. 30 seconds per lap, you get 10 points, so it's actually quite hard, and this is what I think makes the game challenging, I guess, because with the squirrel training, it helps you beat the game, be able to beat the bosses, really, because with items, it depends on the run, with items you usually have enough power to get through the areas. Good rolling, that kind of thing. But then, when there are bosses, you need to have a reserve. And I stop running. 10 is enough, because you, in order to make a run, you are mashing the button like a madman. So it's actually quite hard. And the other one for magic is takes concentration. So you'll see that later. Ah, fish bones again! No! The putrid stew. Drink it. Yes. Taste the putrid stew. It's an original experience. I've never had anything like this before. It's awful. I know. Have some more. Take it all in. It's drained me of my magic. Fish bones again. Ah, still no items. Sorry, bud. So, as the story begins, there's basically, we have the two brothers, and one's like, oh, I'll do the dishes, you go on ahead, or something like that, and, that's right, they're going to a festival, there's basically a big fair or whatever, and they have to get across the river. It's in another town, there's a spot where there's a big festival, so they go in there, maybe it's International Peace Day or something like that, something great. Yeah, peace and love, woohoo! And, so the younger brother goes to get his friends, and you don't have to get the penguin, I don't think you have to get Pen-Pen. And, but I do. Get the girl, get Pen-Pen, and ready to rock, they're a cool squad. And the only thing about Pen-Pen is, well, Pen-Pen is watching you. And that sweet dance. It's a nice dance, too. Yeah, So we don't know what the Nihilist plot is, but they're planning something. That's what the intro suggested. I looked up in the wiki, and I saw a couple episodes of the anime, of the animation, and, the story, I don't know, there's something about the remnants of the Empire or something. They're trying to awaken the power of a dragon or something. I mean, whatever you want. That's not in my head. In my head, it's... they want to, eliminate the time travelers and revert it back to the original timeline. And to do so, they must destroy the Ninku! So since you don't always have to go forward, you can kind of go around as you want. You could, if you want, to grind and grind and grind to get the stuff that you need. And you really only need to grind for bosses, so I get a 6, and hey, let's just move ahead. Fish bones again. Putrid stew. It's the fashion. You must try my putrid stew. Don't mind if I do. And you thought it was a good guy, but your ninja powers weren't able to protect you from the fate of the putrid stew going down your throat and then being vomited back up. Okay, more squirrel training. This time I go for magic. And as you can see, squirrels and the Nihilist luchador masks. If you choose the luchador mask, you go back down to 0, so it takes some concentration. And I usually get about 34, a little more than that. 42 is the highest I remember getting. Maybe I've done more. I only remember 42. Yep. Hey, 36. Respectable. So the different powers, I don't use them at the beginning too much, but on the bottom, some characters have the high or low, so your dice will always roll 1, 2, or 3, or will always roll 4, 5, or 6. And the others have the log, which I didn't really use. It's more useful in the multiplayer, just kind of like Mario Party. That's if you choose the second one in the original menu. And you have the log, so you roll a die normally, but if you don't like it, you turn it into a log, you get to roll again. Or you have the roll two dice, which is quite good too. And I'll use that a bunch later. There's the bridge. Now that bridge is blocking us, so it's not us blocking that bridge. I don't go check it out because it just stops you, there's no vent or anything. But that's where we want to go, across that bridge, and we can't, so what are we gonna do? Well, we got Pen-Pen, we got the girl, the brother, he's still at home. In the next chapter, maybe we'll see. Meanwhile, yes, we of course we will. But for now, we're off to see our friend. He's one of those guys that can fix things, get stuff done. I ignore the house this time. There might be an item there, I forget. And, so we're going to see our friend. He's one of my favorite characters. They're all kind of cool. They're all different. Another fight, this time with a bear. I don't think there are any other stats. Ooh, I miss. Yes, the magic. Usually, the one on the left is cost less, and it almost always damage. I think it is always damage, the small one. It gives you a nice hit of damage. The one on the right, for the magic attacks, is either a stun, or some kind of other thing that is stunned, but maybe does other stuff that I don't understand, or can't confirm, or it is a supercharged attack, so it's pretty sweet. So I got the stun on the bear, and I just wail and wail and wail. The thing is, there is, some enemies will take less damage, and some characters will do more damage. So I guess there's hidden stats that you don't get to look at, you don't get to see. Just status. Here, changing characters. Oh, Pen. I take Pen, and he is watching you. You can see he's watching you. Pen is watching. It kind of scared me as a kid, actually. Am I going to grind? No, just go ahead and finish it. There's no boss at the end of this chapter, so it's all good. Oh, spoiler! Haha, I've got some items. What can he take? Give me your Pokemon badges! Yes, well, I got this game after Pokemon, but because I got his used game. But this game came out before Pokemon, actually. 95. At least in North America. North America was 98, I guess. What I remember. And this is the best guy, I think, to get, because this is how you get items. You get a random item, and one to six of them. And I get the mask, which is basically an escape. Most of the items give you either health or magic. And there's also the underpants, which stun an enemy. I always thought that was hilarious. Don't ask me why that's what it is, but I don't know, maybe it's... You got the underpants. Maybe it's hard to find underpants in this world. Underpants! Yes, I need those! They change their underpants or something like that. And here's the fine gentleman. He may be one of the brothers, too. There's something at the start with, like, a three, so maybe it's the third brother. He's the most eccentric one. Working in this shop here with Craig's barrels and three wrenches. But I guess he's kind of like a mechanical guy, whatever. He's got his grease monkey suit on right now. And so they're talking, going to the fair, I guess. The bridge is blocked. Well, how are we going to get there? There was a nihilist. What? The nihilists are back. Ha! They're not going to stop us from having fun. Five something. Five, I don't know what five, but something five. I'll get you there in 5 minutes. We'll take my plane. And that was a hammer, I guess, so. Knock it out of the park, or maybe he's singing a song, an ode to Captain Hammer. And yes, the brothers are happy to be together again. Did you forget, Pen? I was having a little nap here. And they hop in a plane, and watch closely. Spin landing. I guess it's a spin landing. We never see the plane again, so maybe they crashed. I don't know. Launch pad. McQuack style. Oh, or maybe the plane was sabotaged by the nihilists. They didn't want us to get here, but we got here anyway. But we didn't quite get to the fair where we were going. So since the nihilists are about, and it's true, I will fight. Yes, and I fight naked. Remember, I fight naked. And he's naked for the rest of the game. I just threw me off to see that, and she's mad too. The nihilists. Getting in the way of peace. So, that's all we're gonna do for today. End of the episode 1. And, I'll see you next time. Hope you...